YouTube. So today I'm going to go over how to set up your own router instead of the stock AT&T U-verse router, which I believe is a G router. So if you wanted some faster speeds and let's say a dual band router, you can order one online. And pretty much what you want to do is hook up the Ethernet on the back of your new router to one of the yellow ports on your AT&T U-verse router. Once you do that, you want to open up your browser, go to 192.168.1.254. That's the default IP address for your G router of your AT&T U-verse. Now, I just recently upgraded to the 24 megabits per second. And what you want to do is go under settings. You want to go to event notifications and enable detection of router behind router conditions. Once you save, it will ask you for the password. The password is your device access code that is located on your default AT&T U-verse router. So once you save that, you want to go back home. Go under wireless. You want to, the wireless interface, you want to disable that. If you can see my Wi-Fi is right here, the AT&T 413, that is the AT&T U-verse router. Once I disable this, this will go away, and then it will pretty much block out any interferences that the G router will try to make with your new router. Mine is a dual band 2.4 gigahertz and 5 gigahertz, 300 megabits per second up to. So that's family 5, and that's what I'm connected to. So once you disable that, you go down, you click save. It'll ask you for that device access code again, which is located on your AT&T U-verse router. Click submit. If it is successful, you should get this green box, and you are done. Now it is using your new router, and when you go here, this AT&T will eventually disappear because it is, and this way it will interfere with your new router. I can keep refreshing this. There it goes. It goes away. Hope this helps.